Hi, everybody. So today I'm going to talk about some of my lab's work on developing pro healing biomaterials to treat inflamed tissues and inflammation across the body. Of course, this is a COVID session, but we're just starting to work on COVID. So I'll give you a little bit of the background of how we developed these therapies and how now we're trying to tackle COVID-19 related inflammation. So obviously with CIRM, everybody is typically focused on stem cells and cells which make up obviously the major component of our tissues. But our tissues are not just made up of cells. They're also made up of an extracellular matrix, which consists of this fibrous architecture that the cell sits in and is bound to. It's what gives our tissue structure. But it's not just a physical structure. It actually provides very important cues to cells in every tissue of the body. And it provides cues for pretty much all aspects of cell behavior. So this can be cell survival, differentiation, division, or even migration. And so it's really important when thinking about trying to heal damaged tissue that we not only think about just the cell component, but also this extracellular matrix component. And so this is something that we think about a lot and as a biomaterials lab. And so we try to design materials that can mimic or replace the extracellular matrix and promote endogenous healing. And so one other thing I'd like to point out about the extracellular matrix is it's quite specific to each tissue. So there's cardiac extracellular matrix is different than, say, your lung extracellular matrix. And this picture down here is actually of cardiac extracellular matrix where all the cells have been stripped out. And so you can see it has this kind of fibrous architecture, and this is what the cells see and sit inside. So to design a biomaterial to replace in a diseased tissue or an inflamed tissue, what is typically damaged extracellular matrix, and to try to replace it with a more normal extracellular matrix that will recruit stem cells and promote healing, we've designed a number of injectable biomaterials, which we call extracellular matrix hydrogels. They're actually designed from what nature has given us in the first place, which is the extracellular matrix in our tissue. So we take actually our starting materials from pigs. So we take, in this case, image here is porcine muscle. So it's actually the loin, for those of you who cook. So it's porcine loin that we chop into small pieces. We decellularize it, or we remove all of the cells, leaving behind just the extracellular matrix. We then lyophilize it, which means freeze dry it, and mill it into a fine powder, and then use an enzyme to digest it and make it into a liquid. And what's really interesting is that when you take this liquid and you put it back into the body, you inject it back into, say, a diseased tissue, it forms this porous and fibrous scaffold, very similar to the original extracellular matrix. So this inset here is actually this stage here, where you just have isolated extracellular matrix, but before we've done the processing. And you can see the architecture in terms of the pores and fibers is actually quite similar. And then if you look at our extracellular matrix hydrogels under an electron microscope, you see it has this nice nanofibrous architecture, which is the same size scale as the native extracellular matrix. So we've made these extracellular matrix hydrogels from porcine skeletal muscle, also porcine cardiac tissue, since in my lab, one of our main focuses is on treating the heart after a heart attack, and also treating skeletal muscle in the case of peripheral artery disease, where it has low blood flow, is particularly to your legs. But you can generally do this similar type of process to create ECM or extracellular matrix hydrogels from all different kinds of tissue. So just to give you a little bit better idea of how you make these tissues, this is just a short video of one of my former grad students kind of just going quickly through that process.
Hi, my name is Jean Wang, and I'm a first-year MD-PhD student in the Christman lab, and this is how we make our therapy for treating heart attacks. So we get heart tissue, and the first step is we chop it up into tiny pieces, and we put it into a bath, like a beaker right here, and stir it up with detergent to remove all the cellular contents. After a couple days, we rinse it out to remove all the detergents, and all we really have left are the structural proteins that make up a tissue. So we take that and we freeze dry it into this styrofoam-like substance. It's really light and crispy. So it's freeze-dried, and then we take this and we mill it into a fine powder that looks like this. We take that and digest it with an enzyme to liquefy it. You can see that there's liquid at the bottom of this, and this little bead is just stirring it up and keeping everything well mixed. And then finally, we take the liquid form of this and we inject it into the heart, into damaged heart tissue. And once the liquid hits body temperature, it forms a gel that looks like this, and it no longer flows anymore.
So that gives you hopefully a good visual on what these kind of materials look like. It's actually quite a simple process to make them. And we've shown the potential for endogenous, meaning repairing, having the body repair itself and recruiting stem cells in a variety of different types of preclinical models. So we've shown in a heart attack model, this is actually a pig model, in blue is our cardiac extracellular matrix hydrogel injected 2 weeks after a heart attack and going out to 3 months, showing significant improvements in cardiac function. We've also tested in a rat peripheral artery disease model, our skeletal muscle, as well as a couple other extracellular matrix hydrogels. And you can see here in green and blue are two ECM hydrogels that we've tested. And this is showing increased perfusion, which is increased blood flow compared to a saline control, suggesting that you can create increased blood flow, which would help with peripheral artery disease. And then we've also found in the case of our skeletal muscle material that you get increases in skeletal muscle stem cells, which are these PAX7 positive stem cells. So overall, we've seen a lot of success with endogenous tissue repair with our extracellular matrix hydrogels. And across the board, we've really found that they're pro-survival, meaning they prevent further cell death and tissue damage. They recruit stem cells. And then importantly, especially in talking about in a minute here about COVID-19, is that they're immunomodulatory, meaning they influence the immune response. And instead of having a pro-inflammatory response, it shifts it to a pro-remodeling and healing one. Also importantly, the potential to move this into the clinic is there. So a company I co-founded, Ventrix, did a phase 1 clinical trial with the cardiac material in heart attack patients showing initial safety. So this is still undergoing clinical development, but I think these early results are great for proving that you could use this safely in other potential disease indications. So we've now developed a new version of our extracellular matrix that we call a soluble extracellular matrix to enable a different form of delivery. What I just showed you, those materials were injected directly into the tissue, either the heart or skeletal muscle, but we wanted something that could be delivered through the vasculature to tissues that are diseased or have inflammation. And so we go through the same process that we just showed you and through the video up to D here. And then what we do is we fractionate it and remove these insoluble components and leave behind just the soluble component that can be re-dried, rehydrated with sterile water prior to injection. If you inject it just under the skin, it will form a gel. But when you deliver it intravascularly, meaning inject into the bloodstream, it will actually target and gel at the areas of inflamed tissue. So here's an example of a rat heart that has been given a heart attack, and our material was fluorescently labeled. And so you can see it is actually retained at the infarct or the region of heart attack. And then if you look at with a microscope at tissue sections, you see the material actually gels and fills in the gap. So this is the material here is in red of leaky vasculature. So in areas of inflammation, the endothelial cells that line our blood vessels actually become leaky. And it appears that the material will seal off this leaky vasculature. And in fact, in the heart attack model, we've studied extensively showing that it reduces vascular leakage. It's pro-remodeling, it's immunomodulatory, and actually found that it was pro-survival. So because of all of those effects, we thought that this has significant potential to treat other diseases with inflammation like COVID-19. So what we've done so far is we've tested a couple different animal models of lung inflammation. So lung inflammation is not the only issue with COVID-19, but it's obviously one of the major issues that people die from is excessive inflammation. And so we've tested two models so far. The one I'm showing you here is an acid model where you deliver acid to the lungs in a rodent model to create inflammation. And then we delivered our soluble extracellular matrix just via the IV delivery, so intravenous injection. And we fluorescently tag the material again, and you can see it lights up the lungs. If you deliver just saline, you see no signal. And if you deliver the soluble extracellular matrix in a healthy animal, you see nothing. So it really only targets the areas of inflammation. And then this is in a second model of actually both lung inflammation and systemic inflammation. So it's a little bit better model for COVID-19. It's where you inject what's called a lipopolysaccharide. It's made from bacteria. You inject it into the bloodstream and it causes systemic or basically inflammation across the body, but particularly in the lungs. Again, if you take just healthy animal, inject a soluble extracellular matrix, you see no retention, but in this LPS model, so area of inflammation, you again see major retention of the soluble material in the lungs. And we actually saw it in some of the other inflamed organs as well. So now with CIRM funding, we are testing to see if this is in fact immunomodulatory, and we'll kind of put a halt on inflammation and ideally create a pro-remodeling response that would lead to lung healing. And eventually we'll examine other organs too. But right now, our focus is really on the lungs to try to dampen that overactive lung inflammation that's leading to death in many of the COVID-19 patients. So to briefly summarize, I've shown you hopefully, or at least briefly, that extracellular matrix hydrogels are a great technology for promoting endogenous or the body's own tissue repair. We now have this new soluble extracellular matrix form that can treat inflamed tissue via the vasculature, which makes it really great for delivery, just a simple intravenous injection, so very minimally invasive. And based on all the results we've seen with the extracellular matrix hydrogels and the soluble extracellular matrix in these other models showing that they're immunomodulatory and recruit stem cells, we think this really has significant potential to treat the overactive lung inflammation as well as other organ inflammation and tissue damage related to COVID-19. And with that, just briefly, I'd like to thank all my current and former members who contributed with the development of these biomaterial technologies, and of course, funding, particularly CIRM, who's funding our work for ECM hydrogels for peripheral artery disease, and now for trying to translate this to COVID-19 patients. So thank you very much.